Konnichiwa. This is Scott Carbonara, the leadership therapist, with your Lead to Engage thought for the day. Konnichiwa. That's a Japanese word I just learned. It means hello. There are a lot of words in the Japanese language that we use in English. For example, emoji, tsunami, karaoke, haiku, koi, tofu, and of course, who could forget sushi? But my favorite Japanese word is ikigai. There is no one-word translation of ikigai into English, but it essentially means your reason for jumping out of bed each morning. If you want to remember how to pronounce it, think of that nice guy you dated a few times in college. He was sweet, kind, smart, but after just a few dates, you realized he was actually an ikigai. Okay, that's how you pronounce it. Now you can remember. Ikigai has four components to it. The first is, what do you love doing? That's called passion. Secondly, what does the world need? That's your mission. That's how you want to live your life to help others. The third is, what are you good at doing? That might indicate your vocation. And finally, what can you get paid for doing? That might indicate your profession. Here's where some people get it wrong. See, they focus on that last one, what can I get paid for, first. Actually, it's number four in the priority of ikigai for a reason. So for example, if you're on LinkedIn, have you ever got an invite to connect with someone on LinkedIn, and then 2 minutes after you accept that connection, you get an email that says, wow, it seems like we have a lot in common. I've looked over your website. I think I could really help you generate new business. Why don't you sign up for a free call and I can tell you my, okay, you're trying to get into my wallet. You're trying to build your business. You haven't shown me any value. All you've done is you've tried to get paid for something. The focus has to be on really the passion, your mission, and your vocation of serving others first. Then what you can get paid for comes from that. The world is full of takers, but what the world needs is givers. That's why philosopher and civil rights leader Howard W. Thurman said, don't ask what the world needs, ask what makes you come alive and go do it. Because what the world needs is more people who have come alive. Living your ikigai starts with what you love doing. When I lost my job several years ago, I started looking at what are the things that I most love doing. And then I asked myself, what does the world need? That's my mission. How can I help other people? From there, I discovered what might make a job. Living your ikigai starts with doing what you love. That passion fuels your mission, which is how you help others. From there, you can find out, how do you monetize that? How can you make money doing it? Western sociologists haven't often studied Eastern cultures. That'll change when Daniel Butner wrote the book Blue Zones, and I highly recommend that you read it. His research focused on two things. Where do people live longest? So it was about longevity. And then where people seem happiest? You know what he found is the key to a long life and a happy life? You guessed it. Ikigai. I've known since even before high school that I had a passion. What made me happy was to serve others. So when I worked with inner city kids in high school, I knew that was part of my passion. When I worked in a group home with delinquents and gang members, that was my passion. When I worked with those who were abused and neglected, I knew that was my passion. When I went into corporate America and I started coaching and consulting with groups where they had friction and they needed to have higher productivity and they needed to have more open communication, I knew helping them, that was my passion. And I know today in my work, when I'm equipping leaders, enriching cultures, and elevating lives, I'm doing what I love to do. Now it's your turn. What makes you come alive? If you're a leader and you have a team, what can you do to help your employees to come alive? This is Scott Carbonara with Lead to Engage. If you like this message, please feel free to share it, like it, visit me on leadtoengage.com for other tips and blogs. Until next time, stay grounded, and I don't know how to say goodbye in Japanese. Oh, sayonara. Sayonara.